Hello. In today's video, we shall learn in detail about Chlamydomonas, a green algae belonging to family Chlorophyceae. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding about the structure of Chlamydomonas, its various modes of reproduction, and about its life cycle. Let us start with the introduction to class Chlorophyceae. Class Chlorophyceae consists of green algae. They are the most widely distributed group of algae. They are found in all kinds of habitat. The members of Chlorophyceae exhibit different variety in form and shape of their thallus. They may be motile like Chlamydomonas, the simplest form of green algae, non-motile like Chlorella, filamentous like Spirogyra and Eulothrix, siphonaceous like Vaucheria, palmilloid like Tetraspora, and so on. The chief pigment of green algae are chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B, accompanied by small amount of yellow pigment xanthophyll and orange pigment carotenoid. The class is characterized by the presence of pyrenoid and starch as chief food material. Reproduction takes place by vegetative, asexual, and sexual means. Sexual reproduction is accomplished with the help of motile gametes. It ranges from isogamy to oogamy. Let us discuss about Chlamydomonas in detail. First, systematic position of Chlamydomonas. Class Chlorophyceae, order Volvocales, suborder Chlamydomonadinae, family Chlamydomonadaceae, and genus Chlamydomonas. Let us study about the structure of Chlamydomonas. They are primitive, unicellular green algae, usually pear-shaped and biflagellate. The cell is surrounded by a definite cell wall for protection of protoplast. The major structural component of cell wall is glycoprotein. Inner to the cell wall is present a semi-permeable cell membrane or plasma membrane. The most prominent structure in the protoplast is a single cup-shaped chloroplast. It is thick at the bottom and thin at the periphery and anterior end. At the pointed anterior end, there are thin, long, thread-like structure called flagella. There are two contractile vacuoles at the anterior end. They are supposed to be the organs for excretion. A single pyrenoid is embedded in the chloroplast with a starch sheath. The flagellated cells have eye spot or stigma in the anterior portion, which remains inserted at one side of the chloroplast. A single nucleus is present in the inner cytoplasm where Wallichian grains may also be present. The reserve food is starch composed of amylose and amylopectin. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Next, let us learn about reproduction in Chlamydomonas. Reproduction takes place by vegetative, asexual, or sexual means. Vegetative reproduction is by cell division and fragmentation. Asexual reproduction is by the formation of zoospores, aplanospores, hypnospores, pamela stage. Sexual reproduction is by isogamy, anisogamy, and oogamy. Asexual reproduction takes place during favorable condition by the formation of zoospores. First, the cell withdraws its flagella and becomes non-motile. Contractile vacuoles disappear, and the protoplast slightly withdraws from the cell wall. The contents of the cell undergo repeated longitudinal division at right angles to one another, forming 8 cells. These cells are called zoospores. They remain surrounded by the parent cell wall. Before liberation, they form their own cell wall and flagella. Dissolution of the parent cell wall takes place and the zoospores are liberated. Each zoospore behaves like a new Chlamydomonas cell. During zoospore formation, if unfavorable condition occurs, the zoospores are not liberated. The parent wall gets gelatinized and zoospores undergo repeated division. The entire structure gets enlarged and is called palmella stage. During favorable condition, the zoospores are liberated and they lead an independent life. Chlamydomonas may also reproduce by aplanospores and hypnospores. During unfavorable condition, the contents recede from the cell wall and the whole structure comes to rest. It is known as aplanospore and is non-motile. On the return of favorable conditions, the old wall of the parent is cut off and the new cell walls are formed. They either directly give rise to a new plant or the protoplast divides to form more zoospores. Another mode of asexual reproduction is by hypnospores. Hypnospores are formed during severe drought. The walls become thicker and undergo a resting period. During favorable condition, new individuals are formed as explained in the case of aplanospores. Next is sexual reproduction in Chlamydomonas. Sexual reproduction in Chlamydomonas ranges from isogamy to oogamy, which involves 2 gametes. In isogamy, both the gametes are similar in shape, size, and structure. They are morphologically similar but differ in physiology. In anisogamy, both the gametes are dissimilar morphologically. The male gamete is smaller in size compared to the female gamete. In oogamy, the male gamete is smaller in size than the female gamete and is motile, while the female gamete is larger and non-motile. The thallus may be homothallus, that is, Both male and female gametes are produced in the same thallus, or it may be heterothallus, that is, plus strain and minus strain gametes come from different parents. Let us learn about isogamy. In isogamy, isogametes come very close to each other by their anterior ends. The wall at the point of contact dissolves, resulting in the formation of diploid quadriflagellate structure. Plasmogamy is followed by karyogamy. Plasmogamy is fusion of cytoplasm, and karyogamy is fusion of nuclei. In many isogamous species, the vegetative cells may directly function as gametes. The two gametes come close to each other by their anterior ends and later fuse. It results into a quadriflagellate binucleate structure with two pyrenoids, two eye spots, etc. The zygote remains motile for few days. Isogamy is the most common type of sexual reproduction. First, the protoplast withdraws from the cell wall, divides mitotically to form 32 to 64 daughter protoplasts. Each develops a pair of flagella and behaves as a gamete. The wall of gametangium breaks and the gametes are liberated. In heterothallic species, plus strain and minus strain gametes cluster together, and the process is known as clumping. Fusion takes place between the two different strains of gametes. The wall at the place of contact dissolves, resulting in fertilization. Plasmogamy is followed by karyogamy. The quadriflagellate zygote formed loses its flagella, gets covered by a thick wall, and is now known as a zygospore. Next is an isogamy. The two gametes are unequal in size. The male gamete, known as the microgamete, is small in size and is formed in the male gametangium. 16 active gametes are formed by the division of the protoplast. Female gametes or macrogametes are large and formed in the female gametangium. In this case, the protoplast divides and forms only 2 to 4 gametes. The male gamete, being active, come close to the female gamete. Protoplast enters from the male into the female gamete. Fusion takes place and a diploid zygote is formed. This zygote develops a thick wall around itself and is now known as a zygospore. Next is oogamy. The vegetative thallus, which functions as the female gamete, withdraws the flagella and acts as non-motile macrogamete or egg. The microgametes formed by the division of protoplast reaches the female, comes in contact by the anterior end. The wall at the point of contact dissolves. Plasmogamy takes place, followed by karyogamy. The zygote formed develops a thick wall around itself and forms a zygospore. Finally, we shall look into the germination of zygospore. The zygospore is known as the resting spore. It is a diploid structure having a large amount of oils and starch. It germinates during favorable condition. The diploid nucleus undergoes meiosis or reduction division, resulting in the formation of 4 haploid nuclei. The 4 daughter protoplasts formed have 1 haploid nucleus each and behave as a zoospore. The diagrammatic life cycle of Chlamydomonas shows both the asexual and sexual process of reproduction. Asexual reproduction, as already discussed, shows the formation of zoospores by mitotic division, while in sexual reproduction, there is formation of gametes, pairing, plasmogamy, karyogamy, zygote formation, reduction division, resulting in the formation of new cells. So today, we have learnt in detail about the structure of Chlamydomonas, various modes of reproduction, and also its life cycle. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comment section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.